I'm joined now by Julian Bowers. Been farming here for 25 years, I think, Julian, in partnership with your brother.
That's right.
And so I've known the farm for most of that time. You were a dairy farmer. Now we've got some Angus finishing on multi-species lays.
I think this is the future. I think grazing outside, you know, on a multi-species lay, without fertiliser, pesticides, fungicides, insecticides, a more higher-end quality animal is the future.
Yeah. And what's a particular thing that you're looking at? What's your sort of your interest really that made you think multi-species is going to be the crop for me?
Well, I started off looking at soils, thinking how can I improve my soils, and the more I looked at it, the more diversity came into this. And you know, I started seeing things about herbal leys, and I thought, yeah, this has got a lot going for it. You know, let's have a look, let's see what this is.
So we've actually put this into a GS4.
Yes.
It's your establishment last year after cereals.
That's correct.
August time.
Yes.
And we've just started grazing it now. But can you tell me a little bit about what you think your inputs are going to be in terms of a fertiliser, P and K? How are you going to manage the crop in terms of feeding it?
I think we've always been a very fertile farm. We've all coming from a dairy background, and always carrying, you know, good amount of stock. We've always put muck on the ground. P and K indices are very good.
Yeah.
And as far as nitrogen's concerned, you know, we've got dirty water, stroke digestate type of product that, you know, we can put on these fields if we think they need it.
Yeah. And other than that, it's just completely low input.
Yes, completely. Yeah. I'm hoping that the grazing that we're doing, the cows moving up, you know, and fertilising as they go.
Yeah. Grazing depositions.
Is going to be a great benefit.
Yeah. So the key thing seems to me here, to me, looking at it, you've got good plant numbers. You know, there's no issues. It's been a relatively clean farm because you've always looked after it well. You've always grown clover here. Red clover, I remember years and years ago, you were a pioneer. Zero grazing red clover lays. So clearly you can grow herbs and legumes quite easily here.
I think that was some of it. I think we know we can grow clover.
Yeah.
So I know you had to tailor the GS4 to our specifics because we're not a light farm.
Yeah.
So we were never going to grow lucerne, you know, type of things, but we're more clover based on that lay. But you know, it's been a great take. The clover looks well, you know. I think we've got that side of it pretty good in this field, in all we've done.
Yeah, it looks good. So, Julian, Angus cross beef scheme. You're grazing them, obviously. How are you going to manage the grazing? What's the sort of the aims of your grazing scheme here? Are we sort of trying to hit residuals of 4 centimetres? Are you trying to build a bit more organic matter? How's your grazing going to, you're going to manage that grazing?
I want great daily live weight gains. I want them to take the majority of it, but not all of it.
Yeah.
You know, and we're going to move up this field. You know, I'm going to have something like, you know, a 35 to 40 day turnaround back onto the same plot again to, you know, to cover all the standards required.
The management required.
The management required. Well, and, you know, I think we can get some good daily live weight gain out of that, and I think we can also look after the soil.
So when you say good daily live weight gain, 1.25 kilos, something like that, do you think we can hit?
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be very nice.
They do look tremendous.
Yeah, they do look well, yeah.
Yeah. Have you found any issues in terms of the multi-species and establishment and management of your multi-species so far?
Not really. I think they've established very well, especially following cereals.
Yeah.
You know, direct drilled into a stubble.
Yeah.
You know, we've got a few volunteer cereals, but it's been a brilliant take.
Yeah.
So far so good.
Good. Yeah. There's one or two annual. Well, you've got your cereals, haven't you? And a few annual broadleaf weeds, but they're gonna disappear.
For sure. Yeah. And hopefully the grazing, you know, will take care of that.
Be interesting. We did do some soil organic matters, didn't we? So we can come back in a few years and see.
Yes.
And see what impact we've had on soil organic matter.
Yes.
So multi-species, beef finishing, Angus finishing, what are going to be the real positives for you if we can make this work?
We're trying to get positives from everywhere. We're trying to reduce daily workload.
Yeah.
We're trying to look after the soils.
Yeah.
We're trying to get good daily live weight gains.
Yeah.
And we're trying to be far less reliant on fertilisers and chemicals.
And bought in feed.
If I can finish these, you know, on this type of crop,
they're
great.
Yeah, excellent.